most famous arena. Here are the starting lineups for today's first game. For Old Dominion University, at the forwards, number 25, Mark Davis. Number 44, Kenny Gattison. At center, number 55, Clarence Hanley. And at the guards, number 20, Charles Smith. And number 24, Keith Thomas. And here's the coach of Old Dominion University, Paul Webb. For Rutgers University, at the forwards, number 12, Chris Remley. Number 54, Steve Perry. At center, number 34, Lloyd Moore. And at the guards, number 10, John Battle. And number 24, Brian Ellerby. The officials, Bob Diaz, Bob Barnett, and Frank Scaglietta.
Here are the officials now, Bob Diaz, Bob Barnett, and Frank Scaglietta. So that's the lineup of the three men who will be officiating the game. And the lineups for the teams, you've just heard. Rutgers University, they're 4-3 from New Brunswick, New Jersey. Old Dominion University Monarchs from Norfolk, Virginia. Their record is now 5-2. John Battles, the leading scorer for both these sides as we look at the starting lineups, and we'll see a lot of action. This is what may be considered a real test. Both these teams have had good early season, but here at the Holiday Festival, strong opponents. All these teams came in with winning records. Four different conferences are represented in the Holiday Festival, and now we're set to go. And of course, the championship game coming up next will match St. John's University, the Red Men, against NC State Wolfpack, and both those teams have 7-1 records. Old Dominion, and they're wearing their blue and white uniforms, and Rutgers, the white uniforms with the red lettering and red numerals. And for Old Dominion, big man that you see, Hanley, 25, Davis, they'll move that ball well. Charlie Smith, this is he, number 20. And the first shot of the game missed by Davis, and the follow-up also missed by Gattison. Now Rutgers, Perry, number 54. Ellaby.
Both teams opening up strong man for man. This is a feeling out process. Starting man helps you to get in gear.
Moore, good pass to Perry, but it wouldn't go. And we saw that contact right there as Gattison was putting the ball up, Kenny Gattison. And the player control foul is the call. Coming in the ball game now, number 00, Eric Riggins from Passaic Tech High School, Passaic, New Jersey, who was academically ineligible during the first part of the season, his third game now. They missed his services earlier. Moore on the throw-in. And Ellaby, he had quite a day in the opening game here, didn't he, Bucky?
Yes, he did. Broke the school record. 16 assists. That's a night's work. The amazing thing about that is the top gun in the backcourt that he really requires to make those assists went 7-for-20. John Battle did not have a good night. That made those 16 assists even more remarkable.
But Battle gets his first one right now. So John Battle, who started off so slowly in the opening encounter, came into the Holiday Festival averaging almost 24 points a ball game, has given Rutgers the quick 2-0 lead. And Smith finds the mark. Charlie Smith. Ball game knotted at 2 in the early going. They'll keep coming in here right throughout the course this afternoon. Moore, he cleared a pretty good path coming down the middle, didn't he? Who's going to get in the way?
Looked like jackpot bowling there. I'll tell you what, you draw the charge on Lloyd Moore this early on a bright, sunny Saturday. You're tough. At 260 pounds, they list Lloyd Moore rather conservatively, I think. And when he gets up ahead of steam, I'd move.
Yeah, I wouldn't blame you. Hanley on that foul. This is Moore with the ball. He's still a growing boy, though, Bucky. Look at it that way.
Yeah, he's on that seafood diet. He sees food, he eats it. Key here, Steve Perry, really the guts of the Rutgers team in terms of boards and defense, taken out only after two trips up and down the floor. Looks like he might have turned an ankle.
Mm-hmm. And Riggins didn't waste much time when he got in there, making the score of Rutgers 4 and Old Dominion 2. They're working on him over there rather feverishly, aren't they, with the ankle.
That's when the trainers earn their money.
Battle. Oh, good play. John Battle, a tri-captain, comes from Washington, D.C. A lot of great players have come from the nation's capital. And the foul is called as well.
Watch this. Little stutter step now. Watch the acceleration. He just goes right by two blue jerseys, wedges up and in. It's that kind of power underneath that gives many the hope that he can be a pro guard. Only 6'2", but he is strong, and he does have that excellent acceleration, and he can take the ball with him. A lot of guys are fast, but they leave the ball somewhere else in the building.
Rutgers lead climbs now to 5 points. They lead 7-2. That foul, by the way, was Hanley's second. His battle made the 3 points. Charlie Smith from outside. Look at this scramble. No basket. There was a travel call, so that nullifies that potential hoop.
But it does give Old Dominion a chance to set up its very fine press. It was this press, not this press. This is a soft man for man. They started the same way Thursday night. It's when they went to that full court zone trap that they really became effective.
Moore is on the left side of the paint, and the ball is on the right side. Riggins trying to get position. Oh, Battle looks like he's going to have a big night tonight, or an afternoon, we should say, as they're starting out, as you can tell, just after noon, New York. 7 points for Battle.
It's a little early for basketball. Our friends out in California are probably still in the hot tub.
Score now 9-2, Rutgers.
It's very difficult when you're playing for third place. In the middle of the day, the building, although we're expecting a fine crowd here in Madison Square Garden, it's still very early, and it's a challenge to these teams. The natural hype that you get playing in the Garden with a good crowd just aren't here yet. They're going on adrenaline now.
Now we've seen the change in the lineup. Tolson has moved in now. He's in there now for Old Dominion. Rutgers has scored the last 7 points to take this 9-2 lead.
Old Dominion's very difficult to defend because of their balanced scoring. The five that started this game basically through most of last year, all in double figures. It really stresses your defense.
Hanley, the miss. Keith Thomas went to the sidelines when Tolson came in. Riggins gets it up. And Riggins follows. Rutgers has now come up with 9 points in a row to take an 11-2 lead in the first 4 minutes of play, Bucky.
Well, Steve Perry may have a tough time getting back in this ball game. I really do think they need him to be a fine team. He always takes a tough defensive man, and he's very, very tough on the boards.
And he's the leading rebounder. He also, as we see a worried Paul Webb across the way, the coach of Old Dominion. Perry also leads Rutgers in blocks and steals. Oh, look at this. And Mark Davis breaks the streak to make it 11-4 after Rutgers had run off 9 points in a row. So that was a rather exciting way to conclude that, the streak. And right now, with 15:51 still to go in the first half of the first game, it's now Rutgers 11 and Old Dominion 4. We'll be back.
It's a busy world we live in. It can take your breath away. When the going is easy, there's an easy
take your time through the airport by reserving your seat in advance. Take a comfortable wide-body plane. Spread out in a spacious business class or stretch out in a first-class sleeper seat. Across the country, across the world, nobody is working harder to make flying easier than everybody at TWA.
We're a spirit you can count on, a hand across the miles. We're a cloud to put your cares on, and an easy smile. You're gonna like us, TWA.
Number 24, Brian Elvey, pretty classy guard, but here he's stripped clean. Mark Davis, co-captain, 6'5", from Chesapeake, Virginia, puts an exclamation point on that one. And with this timeout now, Old Dominion will have the opportunity to set up their pressure. They need to have the clock stopped or at least score to get their downcourt pressure in gear. Rutgers off to a good shooting start. ODU, the same problem as Thursday night, cold hands early.
Part of the excitement of Holiday Festival, the bands, the cheerleaders, the general verve, and the tradition, of course, at Madison Square Garden. Remley, good shooter. Moore. The battleship, Moore. He launched that one, didn't he?
Yes, he did. Got a nice touch. Transferred from Marquette. Gets down about another, Bob gets down about another 30 pounds, and he's going to be a fine center. He's just not in condition now. A lot of injuries have kept that conditioning to be a bit retarded. He can play.
And he grabbed that one as it rolled along the ground.
And did you notice nobody tried to take it away from him?
I noticed. Battle. Hey, Moore has that touch to set. Maybe he likes the daylight more than the nightlight.
Well, I think stamina is a problem, too. When you have a little excess weight, you tend, especially with the tempo of this game, both teams really pushing to go up and down, you may have a little trouble getting tired.
Rutgers leads 15 to 4.
Oh, what a tip.
No basket, they say.
Tolson went over everybody and got that thing back in, but they're not going to give it to him. Now we're down at the other end. There's Lloyd Moore posting up underneath. If you're going to go around him, you better pack a lunch. Too much room. Soft touch, turns and faces, puts it in over Clarence Moose Hanley. We got a couple of big fellas in the post there.
Mm-hmm. The foul by Tolson. Score of the game is 15-4. Rutgers was still early in the first half.
It's very hard to call a guy who weighs 240 pounds Clarence. But when he's 6'10 to go with it, I'll call him whatever he wants.
If you're facing him, you call him Clarence, right?
Call him sir.
Good move. Riggins now has 6 points. So that double O is misleading. He scored.
Well, you know, we talked about that Thursday night. Guys who wear double O are just a little different. But he's made a tremendous adjustment coming in there. The injury to Perry turned out to be a blessing.
Gaddison is his first basket. It's now 17-6, Rutgers. 6 minutes have gone by in this opening half.
The Monarchs are not going to panic. This is a veteran ball club. As we talked about, good D and balance scoring. They'll work their way back in here, bucket at a time.
Riggins. And the whistle on the play. This is an experienced team. They play tough teams in the Sun Belt Conference. Good ball club. Welcome.
Had a chance to meet the new commissioner of the Atlantic 10 yesterday, Charlie Theokas, and he's dynamite leader. Of course, the Sun Belt has a very prominent leader of their conference, Commissioner Vic Bubas, who is also chairman of the NCAA Basketball Committee. Rutgers going to lift bench coming in now, and it looks like both teams are going to exploit the depth which they both have.
So we have new players coming, and it's always a thrill, particularly to have a chance to play at Madison Square Garden. Now Frank Smith is number 15 for Old Dominion, and Keith Thomas, number 24, you just saw, standing right beside him. This is Riggins at the line. The score, Rutgers 17, Old Dominion 6.
Steve Brown, number 14, who just came in for Rutgers, gives a lot of speed. They may be going to extend their defense and do a little pressing. He did a good job when Rutgers made a run on Thursday night with their pressure.
Mm-hmm. And he came also in to get a couple of fouls that some of the other men who were fouled at the Coles wouldn't be charged. 19-6.
Zucker, of course, a sophomore, just playing his way back into condition. Andre Bell, a starter for Rutgers, not even expected to play today. Still injured back.
Almost that time. That was Sylvester Charles, but the follow-up. Gaddison now has his second basket, and it's Rutgers 19 and Old Dominion 8.
Frank Smith, number 15, dogging Browner. That's an excellent matchup. Good athletes, both Blazers.
Oh, there we saw a travel. It was really a slip battle about to start, and his feet just slipped out from under him. So the traveling violation. Rutgers 19, Old Dominion 8. Old Dominion, their first visit during the Holiday Festival to Madison Square Garden. Their first meeting against Rutgers. Thomas. And they look for Charles, who got good position inside. As you saw on the play, quickly Zucker came over number 20 to defend. And on the play, we have the foul committed by Zucker. Paul Webb needs just 3 victories for 500 career wins. Tom Young is approaching not quite as rapidly that 500 mark. Sylvester Charles at the line. He is more famed up to this point for his field goal shooting than for his free throw shooting.
Transfer from Wake Forest actually has been out a year and a half. He played with Wake Forest in this tournament 2 years ago and then transferred. So he's still getting acclimated.
Ellaby is now in for Brown for Rutgers. Sylvester Charles comes from the Virgin Islands. You can see he's had free throw difficulties throughout the year, but from the floor, 61%. Coming into this tournament at the free throw line, he was 4 for 13. Mark Davis.
Excellent execution that time. Old Dominion moving the ball much quicker than Rutgers could move its defense.
Oh, beautiful play. Battle now has 9 points. And he's gone 4 for 4. Thomas, Davis, and Gaddison. That was moving well.
That's what we were talking about at the opening of the show. Kenny Gaddison at 6'8", highly recruited football player. Really is agile, finds the seam down in there, and against St. John's, who's very physical up front, he managed to get 16 points. And again, at the point of that press, his size forces a high trajectory pass, which enables the good quickness behind him to pick it off.
Moore is back in. Remley has left the scene for the moment. Rutgers leads 21-12. 12 minutes to go in the first half of the ball game. Rutgers Conference is the Atlantic 10th. Well, when you're hot, you're hot. John Battle. He went to McKinley High School in Washington, D.C. Last year, his 21 points a game led the Atlantic 10 Conference. He's the leading scorer. He does everything. Score 23-14.
Old Dominion having a hard time getting a second shot.
They just changed that score off the scoreboard to the correct score to 23-12 as we double-checked our figures with Harry Robinson here. So I think we're back in the right format.
Keith Thomas, number 24. Despite the fact Battle is having a good game, has really been close to him. Quick, aggressive, very good overplayer on the overplay defensively.
Now for Rutgers, looks like Steve Perry's ankle has been taken care of, although he comes back with a slight limp.
John Battle on the line, shooting 2. 2 shots you got,
man. 2. And John Battle, who's already rung up 11 points, going for a couple more. 23-12, Rutgers leads. And add 1.
The Rutgers club's very slender, except for Lloyd Moore. And basically, Steve Perry's the enforcer. He's the rejector, the board man. I think they really have to have him against a good club.
He's got 13 points, over half of Rutgers' points, as Rutgers leads by a score of 25-12, and the timeout has been called. So there's a lot more action coming up and a second game to follow. From Madison Square Garden, this is college basketball.
One of the most popular shows in New York is back at MSG Network has it. It features a team of dedicated professionals led by a hero that does the amazing night after night. He's backed by the powerful and the quick, and they can take whatever the opposition throws at them and then dish it right back. And they're all under the watchful eye of a coach who demands the best. It's New York Knicks basketball. Watch Bernard King, Coach Hubie Brown, and the Knicks take on the NBA's best at Madison Square Garden. New York Knicks home games. There's only one place, Madison Square Garden Network.
The score, 25-12. Rutgers is leading the first half, 11:15 to go. Bob Wolf here, Bucky Waters, Bruce Beck at Madison Square Garden, the 33rd Holiday Festival, a great tradition in this 50th year of college basketball at Madison Square Garden, where it all began. John Battle has been the headliner up to this point, 13 points. Riggins is 8 for Rutgers. And Gaddison leaves Old Dominion with 6. Old Dominion has had great teams during the years, not just the men, but now the women. The Old Dominion Lady Monarchs ranked number one. Number one among the women.
Rutgers has been man for man, now changing up, trying to match up in there. Old Dominion very patient. Good pass inside.
Oh, Gaddison went up. The ball was batted out of his hands. The follow-up by Charlie Smith. 25-14.
Old Dominion fortunate to get a second shot that time. I thought he got hammered.
Campbell has moved in the lineup now for Rutgers. Where's number 30? Let's see with the ball. Moore, good pass. I'll tell you, this Moore is getting him where he wants him. That was nestled right up near the glass. 6 points. 27-14, Rutgers. We're past the midway point of the first half.
Very flat 1-2-2, trying to force the Monarchs to shoot from outside.
I was impressed with Tolson's play. He's number 35 in the first game. Did a fine defensive job. Missed by Smith. That's Tolson going up.
The city game. Little pick and roll now for Rutgers. There's Steve Perry going on a bad ankle. Forcing inside over the top. Not enough weak side defense soon enough. And Lloyd Moore is in there all by himself. He's a crowd all by himself.
Campbell. Moore. Good spin by Moore. Sylvester Charles, number 21, and Campbell hooked his arm trying to get the ball away. Now Battle is back. You know, to give you some idea of the prowess of Battle, earlier this season, St. John's defeated Rutgers at the Meadowlands, but John Battle had 38 points in that game. Paul Webb, we see him at the sidelines. One of the assistant coaches, by the way, is his son.
Yes, it's a family affair there. Paul Webb, a William & Mary graduate. This is the second of a five-game road streak for the Monarchs, and I'm sure he would like to get that 500th as soon as possible. And it may be tough on the road, but it would be kind of nice for him to get it at home.
Charlie Smith wished that one in, and here was Battle coming back, and he did more than wish. He plunked it down. 15 points for Battle. 29-16 the score.
Coaches have different theories on players and when Battle had the start that he did, hitting his first five field goal attempts, I don't believe I would have taken him out. Tom Young took him out and put him right back in, and it's good to see that he's stayed right in the offensive flow. There are those coaches who will substitute on a time basis or whatever, but if a guy's playing like that, I let him play till he drops.
As long as they keep dropping in the basket.
That's right. They can't be tired if it's going in. I'd rather have a guy tired and making them than a fresh guy missing them.
Poulsen. He moved over from Frederick Community College. He comes from Oxon Hill, Maryland, and a 6'5 junior. 29-16. Rutgers is leading. 29-17.
There's the trap.
Here's Battle. Look at him go. Beautiful bounce pass. Riggins puts it in.
Well, that's textbook attack of the full court zone press. It didn't happen many times because Old Dominion really made a run at St. John's with that defense. And had they made a couple of free throws, they might have been in the final game.
Charlie Smith is doing a good job, too, offensively. He's got 8 points. Frank Smith, by the way, the small guard who also moves into that Old Dominion lineup, in and out, is not related to Charlie.
He was a fine high school football player, too, Frank Smith. 5'11", freshman from Alexandria, recruited by Notre Dame, Southern Cal, Nebraska. Very physical player, very quick. He was impressive Thursday night. No garden jitters for him.
So Perry is out. And Ellaby is out. This is Steve Brown, number 14, going behind Moore. Battle, Remley on the right side. Riggins moving across the paint. That pass a little off course. We've got a timeout called right now. Some festive fans at the Holiday Festival. Score is Rutgers 31, Old Dominion 19. We'll be back with more action after these messages.
Salted peanuts. Is this the Riviera?
More tropical punch, please.
And then perhaps a dip in the pool.
Planters unsalted peanuts. So crunchy and delicious, their fresh out of the shell taste makes everything special.
Hey, Planters unsalted peanuts. Isn't that nice? To a real cute guy from your adoring fans, we love you, Frank Gifford. Frank Gifford. P.S. Give some to Don.
Let's take a look now at the individual scoring to this point in the game. 7:47 to go in the first half. Battle has been the big man in every way. 15 points. Moore has 6, and Riggins 10. Just 3 men have scored so far for the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. For Old Dominion, their leading scorer, Charlie Smith with 8, Gaddison is 6, Davis is 4, and Tolson is 1.
Eric Riggins' fast entrance into the game with the ankle turn of Steve Perry turned out to be fortuitous for the Scarlet Knights. Riggins just started out hot and hadn't quit.
Let's give you the numbers right now as we see the side shot by Frank Smith. This is Remley. And the ball knocks out of bounds. For Old Dominion, Frank Smith 15. Charlie Smith is 20. Clarence Hanley 55, Sylvester Charles 21, and 35 is Darryl Tolson. Old Dominion, this is Tolson. Frank Smith.
Rutgers adjusting to a 2-3 off the baseline inbounds, but they're matching up.
Tolson. And in the scramble, Ellaby comes up with the ball. Riggins knocked out of his hands. And Rutgers will retain possession as the ball goes out of bounds.
Charlie Smith made an excellent defensive play. Number 20, the 6'3 senior from Wilmington, Delaware. He picked him clean. That was 3-point time. Riggins tough around that basket.
Moore, and on the reach-in, he was trying to get free, called on the travel. Rutgers has Battle, Ellaby. Battle's number 10, Ellaby number 20. Remley wearing number 12, Riggins 00, and Moore's number 35. And now Tolson and Frank Smith leave the lineup. And for Old Dominion, Keith Thomas, who, by the way, is their leading scorer during the season, 15 points a game. He's in.
Paul Webb patiently over there. His team shooting only 42% against 68 for Rutgers in East Town. Just hang in there. Run your stuff. Take good shots. We got a lot of time.
Hamley with the shot. And this is Thomas going up. He makes it. And Keith Thomas has been moving back and forth from the bench back into play as his first two-pointer of the afternoon.
The Monarchs from the Sun Belt are starting to get on that offensive board now. Hanley, who's a fine, soft-shooting big man, gets it up there on the iron soft. And as we've said, second shots have been tough to come by, but Keith Thomas, only 6'3", wiggles his way in there, has a chance for three.
That foul was by Ellaby. Sylvester Charles, a little too hard. And as he grabbed it the second time, we have a jump ball. He was tied up. Thomas' shooting could be a big factor where the Old Dominion can come back, trailing now by 10, 31-21.
It's a jump ball, and of course, the possession time for Rutgers. That's a very fine defensive play because Sylvester Charles was going back up and he was looking down in the basket.
Old Dominion picking up a little more closely. Mark Davis is back in the lineup, and Keith Thomas is in there with him. Battle. And on the play, as Battle was moving toward the baseline, the hand reached out and the foul was committed by Keith Thomas.
Followed by Keith Thomas.
Old Dominion is over the limit. Rutgers is five.
Old Dominion has 17 fouls. Seven.
You know, Bucky, we spoke about John Battle, who was not up to his usual standard in the first game. And that's why it's always difficult either to speak about a player or write about a player, certainly on a one-game performance. It's really the consistency over the course of a year or even more.
Well, he's been consistent over the career, and the problem has been for him this building. He just hadn't played well in this building until today. Well, he's shaking that quick. He's off to a great start.
He now has 16 points. 32-21, Rutgers leading. Mark Davis. He's got a good outside touch. Co-captain of the team. Comes from Chesapeake, Virginia. The travel.
Eric Griggins got himself down there too deep. Ellerby made a sensational bounce pass. About half court. Put it right on the money, but Griggins had himself too far under and had to shuffle to get back to get an angle on the glass.
Clarence Hanley put that ball in play, the big 6'10", 130-pound junior. Brought in the front court, though, by Charlie Smith, who's 6'3", Bloomington, Delaware.
Old Dominion now, gradually, they've got it down to nine, and they're getting second shots.
This is Thomas, and Thomas gets up a second time, and the second time he was fouled.
Very definitely, you can see that momentum change when it... Team begins to get on an offensive board and go to the free throw line a lot. That's going to give him confidence.
You just saw Sylvester Charles leave, and when he did, Kenny Gattison came back in. So he's in the lineup right now. 6'8", 215-pound junior from Wilmington, North Carolina. Thomas now has his third point, and Old Dominion is moving back. It's 32-24. 25 now. Look at that pressing tactics, but it's a three against one. And Battle decided that he'd go for it himself. Battle now has 18 points.
You know, when you full court zone press, some teams, they won't attack the press to the basket, but Rutgers will with Ellaby and Battle at the end of it. That's a fine offense.
At the other end is Moore. However, a travel call. Moore was waiting at the other end.
Moore had gone condo at the other end. He had made no effort to come back out of the paint. He was conserving his energy down there. He let him play 4-on-5 at the other end.
Oh.
some of those offensive rebounds by Old Dominion were made a little more possible as a result of the matchup defense, which isn't very good to eliminate second shots. Now they're back to man for man.
Rutgers with a 9-point lead.
Followed by Eric Riggins.
Riggins, and now both teams are in the bonus situation.
It's been a long, tedious comeback now to get back in within 9 for Old Dominion. They've got to guard against another spurt by Rutgers to take them out to a 14 or 15 at halftime. And even the coach of Paul Webb's experience playing for third place would be pressed to be so eloquent down 15 in the third place game at half.
Kenny Gaddison, as we mentioned in high school, he's an all-state tight end. 6'8", about 220 pounds. Talented all-around athlete. He, too, has had a better field goal percentage during the course of the year than his free throw percentage, which just recently went over 50%. Remley from outside. 36-27 Rutgers, the Scarlet Knights lead. And Charlie Smith, Remley with the ball. This time, as they got the rebound, Battle started a fast break, and except for that foul there, he might have had an opportunity to cash in with two.
You know, Old Dominion has very fine athletes on the perimeter. They all run and jump well, and they're very anxious to get on the offensive board. And oftentimes they get caught down in there following their own shot, that time from the head of the key. And had there not been a foul right there, there was a breakaway layup at the other end.
That's the way it looked. Remley at the line of the Charlie Smith foul. Campbell for Rutgers moves in. And Andre Bell makes an appearance for Rutgers, number 44. Last season led the team in field goal percentage and rebounds per game. Remley at the line.
Well, they badly need some inside strength. The Rutgers, so far, the three losses, to St. John's, at Michigan, and then to NC State the other night. All three opponents had the same marked attributes, and that's a strong inside game. And Rutgers just doesn't have the bodies. Andre Bell is by no means looked like a lifeguard, but he is experienced, and he's done a good job for him.
He wears number 44. And this is Gaddison, the other number 44, for Old Dominion, putting it in. Gaddison now has 10 points to lead the Monarchs. 38-29. Rutgers leading 4.5 to go. First half, Elevate opens up the defense slightly as Charlie Smith comes out. Rumley's at the high post, waves him to go in the other direction. Riggins baseline. Foul was called as he tried to get by the baseline, and there was Gaddison with the push.
During this first game, if you hear a band, it's Rutgers band, and they are really good.
Rutgers' biggest lead in this game was 13 points. It was 25-12 at the time, and right now, Old Dominion closing in somewhat.
Rutgers was down 10 at the half on Thursday night to NC State. Made a sensational run at him. Just came up short.
Riggins on the one-and-one miss. This is Frank Smith in the corner. Davis. Keith Thomas couldn't find the opening, and Davis gets the short shot. But the follow-up, as Sylvester Charles was there for the air ball, he was fouled. Riggins now has his second foul. Nobody is more than two so far in the half. Here's Moore coming back in.
Well, I think that substitution was Moore to get Riggins out of there before he gets his third. With 4 minutes, 2 seconds to go, Riggins has been playing very well. Smart substitution there by Tom Young, and Lloyd Moore is playing well. He needed to be back in there as well.
And Campbell is out, Battle is in, and Zucker is in, and Andre Bell is out. This is Zucker, number 20 that you see along the foul line. Sylvester Charles doing the shooting. 1-1.
It's a very unusual release. I'm not surprised that he's not a good free throw shooter. Watch that ball down in the palm of his hand. And watch the rotation of the wrist. It's not straight.
Sylvester Charles, by the way, played in the Holiday Festival a couple of years ago for Wake Forest, Bucky. So he's making a return appearance. Here's Elevy.
Every other year.
40-30. You were going to make a final comment about that release, I believe.
Yeah, I talked him into that second one.
Keith Thomas. Gaddison. Score 40-32. 3.5 to go. First half. Remley from the side. Say the sharpshooting is on target right now. 42-32.
Both of these teams like the up tempo.
And Gaddis went up. Remley was there. Was that on the ball or was it a foul? They called a foul, but it was close. Let's take a look.
Kenny Gaddison presents a lot of problems for you. He's got the long arms, a 6'8 body, and he's a threat out there. Chris Remley, number 12, now trying to come in from the back. From this angle, it looked like he had the hand on the ball, but if there was body contact, it came from the other side of the floor. It looked like he had the ball. You must remember now that the rule says hand on the ball is part of the ball. So if you smack the hand on the ball, it is not a foul. You have to get the wrist further up. And I think a lot of officials sometimes hear that crack and make a call when it's actually a good block.
Gaddison with 13 points. Ellaby gathers it in. It's 42 Rutgers, 33 Old Dominion. Battle. Zucker. Ed Zucker comes from New Jersey. 6'7 sophomore.
That was John Battle's first miss from the floor, and that one went down in and looked around and came back out.
44-33. Sylvester Charles finds enough room, but is called for a travel, so the basket does not count. Perry will be coming in just a moment for Rutgers. Well, Old Dominion hanging in there. Rutgers, though, leads 44-33. You're watching college basketball from Madison Square Garden.
You can find the speed, power, and excitement of NHL hockey all season long in one place, Madison Square Garden Network. First, you'll have a center-ice view of all New York Rangers home games. With Captain Barry Beck spearheading the defense, goalie Glenn Hanlon denying the opposition, and the Ranger forward line displaying the speed and motion that is the Rangers' trademark under Coach Herb Brooks, the Rangers are aiming for the top, and MSG Network will be there all the way. The center ice view continues on MSG Network with the New Jersey Devils. A young and spirited Devils team under new coach Doug Carpenter is looking to move up in the tough Patrick Division. And they'll concede nothing as they take on their division rivals and the other top teams in the NHL. You'll catch all the action when MSG Network presents both the Rangers and the Devils. From opening faceoff to final horn, preseason to playoffs, the place to be for NHL action is Madison Square Garden Network.
What a game that should be for the championship. North Carolina State against St. John's. I mean, that'll be exciting. Should be, has everything going for it, including two of the most colorful coaches ever to go out on the hardwood.
Oh, yeah, a lot of similarity, Bob. Both of them with 7-1 records. Both of them with fiery Italian leaders who are trying to be contained in the coaching box, the new rule this year. Both of them had big first halves and succumbed to full court pressure defense and made an adventure out of the second half on Thursday night to get to the finals. But that's history. Those are two of the fine names in college basketball. We're talking about franchise names.
Lou Carnesecca, St. John's, and Jim Valvano of NC State. Here's the percentage.
Rutgers, obviously, with the hot hand. Old Dominion has to be pleased that it's in the gym with only 38 compared to that shooting percentage. But we've got a lot of time.
Well, Battle is being guarded by Tolson, and there's Battle with a good pass to Perry. 3-second violation, I believe. That's what it is.
Oh, that's a credit to John Battle. He was up there above the crowd. He's such a fine leaper. He didn't quite have his shoulders squared, but he could have put up a shot that would have been very respectable. And even with the good scoring night that he's having, he looked down inside and found the open man. That shows me something.
This Tolson has impressed me, number 35, with his defensive work, and he's on Battle right now. That's he with the ball, getting his shot up and on the foul by Ellaby. Ellaby comes down writhing with his left arm hurt. Look at that.
Rutgers can ill afford to have him injury. His left shoulder was the injury that kept him out most of the early season. Here we see it. Tolson now making a strong move toward the hoop at 6'5", really putting the pressure on. Gets up in the air. Looks like Ellerby is really trying to get out of the way, and Tolson comes down on that shoulder, and then he turned and fell to the floor. But whatever it is, he's really in pain, and it may well be a re-injury of the left shoulder that has plagued him.
That is just too bad.
It really is. He's a senior, and he's one of those players that you don't hear a great deal about. People think of Rutgers and John Battle, and that's true. He's a fine scorer, but the pair of them are a superb combination in the backcourt. He's a fine point guard.
We'll take a look at this right now from another angle, and Bucky, and see if we can see just when it did happen.
Good shot overhead. Tolson again now going up. He's a little bit out of control. He's falling. And I think Elby got hit almost before Tolson went up, and I'm still not sure where it came.
It could have been that his arm, as he went up, that the arm was hit and sort of wrenched back, and that sort of just that jar did it.
Tolson's very clever. He goes up with that left-handed jumper, and he pulls that right hand away, and he moves it into the defense. He drew a foul on Chris Mullen on Thursday night, and that's an old playground move that is very well evidenced here. He's an Eastern player from Oxon Hill, Maryland, but it may have been that he was pulling that arm away trying to draw the foul, and he cracked Ellerby in that sore spot.
And adding foul to injury. Tolson at the line makes the score 44-34. 2:13 to go in the first half.
Tolson, a highly recruited junior college player. Eastern Basketball Magazine called him the best junior college player in the East.
And who's going to pick it up? Oh. Did you see the way that was picked up? Right between his legs.
Well, we got to talk about that press, because Lloyd Moore is bringing the ball inbounds. And that's going to be nothing but problems for Rutgers. First of all, he's standing under the basket, and at 6'10", he can't throw the ball any length of the floor. He's got to throw it out short, which is exactly where Old Dominion wants that ball to go, along the baseline in the corners. He's got to clear and get away from that board so he can go long.
Now Old Dominion has moved out of the man-to-man into the zone. Battle in the corner. Battle, by the way, till he missed on his last try, had gone 7-for-7. He's now 7-for-8 in the ball game, so he's the hot hand. Rutgers leading 44-35 with a minute and a half to go. And they can take as much time as they want right now, Bucky, with this lead, waiting for either a good shot or the last shot. We approach the minute mark to go in the first half. Rutgers up by 9. They had led by as many as 13.
Both of these teams are much better in transition. Neither one looks that good when they're trying to play it cute.
Steve Brown. And as he went up this time, we have the whistle on the play. He almost forced that one that time. And the foul was called. It would have been sort of a weird shot. It looked like perhaps he felt he was being fouled and got it up. Foul was called against Davis.
Tom Young, the old Maryland player, teammate of Gene Shue. Two fine gentlemen coaching these teams. Paul Webb and Tom Young. Been around a long time.
Mm-hmm. Tom Young's 25th year as a head coach, his 12th at Rutgers. The all-time winning the Scarlet coach. Steve Brown at the line. That's from Trenton, New Jersey. Sophomore. Now Frank Smith yields to Charlie Smith, Old Dominion, as Rutgers leads by 10 with a minute 05 to go.
Charlie Smith, 98th consecutive game for the Monarchs. He's durable.
He is. Here's Davis. Good bank shot. Played that beautifully off the glass.
I really enjoy seeing these two teams run. They do it well.
Look at the press now. Old Dominion putting it on. Perry in the corner. Tom Young is out directing traffic from the bench. Steve Brown with the ball. 40 seconds to go in the half. Rutgers leads 45-37. This is Zucker. Moore comes out. and Battle. Tolson with the vigil on Battle. Stays right there, number 35. And they get Battle on the violation as he moves back and forth, palming the ball.
All right, Old Dominion now, having done very little right in terms of shooting, now has a chance through poise and guts and just hanging in there with 28 seconds. They've got a chance to take it to six.
Keeping a careful eye on the clock, too, right now.
They had dug themselves a 13-point deficit at the half against St. John's. And they missed three free throws. St. John's made three coming down the stretch, or they might have been in the championship game.
Now we're down to 5 seconds to go. The ball swiped away from Gattison. This is Steve Brown. Battle lets fly and misses at the buzzer. That's the end of the first half, and Rutgers leads 45-37. Well, they're close. Old Dominion hanging in right there in this game, trailing by 8 at the half. By the way, stay with us. We've got some exciting halftime activities for you. Luke Karnas second should be on hand. And incidentally, as you know, there have been stories written about Lou and coaching at St. John's. We'll get the inside information on that in just a moment for you. And of course, we'd like to remind you once again that after this first game is over, the battle for third place, it'll be St. John's University Redmond against NC State. So stay right.
Jerick Riggins had 10. Lloyd Moore with 6. Chris Remley had 6 points for the Scarlet Knights. For the Monarchs of Old Dominion, Kenny Gattison with 13. Davis had 8. Charlie Smith had 8 points. And 3 points for Keith Thomas. Set to go for the second half of play. Let's go back to Bob Wolf.
Okay, thank you, Bruce. Brian Ellaby, by the way, was taken to Lenox Hill Hospital to take a closer look at that dislocated left shoulder. It's a recurring injury for him. He missed the first 4 games of the season with it. Looks like his arm was sort of wrenched back and just seemed to pop there. When it happened, he was just 2 assists away from the 2-game assist record of 23 set by Sidney Lowe of NC State.
I'll tell you one thing, tactically it's going to affect Bob Wolf. We can look for Old Dominion to really put that fine press on, because without Ellerby, I'm not sure over 20 minutes that Rutgers can handle that kind of pressure. He's the key to any sort of pressure defense. He's a fine ball handler. You have to think 3 times before you press Rutgers with Brian Ellerby. Somebody else is going to have to take over, and I don't think Battle's a point guard.
The travel call, giving the ball now to Rutgers, Remley. And this is Steve Brown. He's guarded by Charlie Smith. They look for Moore inside, but he's being funded pretty well by big number 55, Hanley. Good play there as Perry kept it alive. It was almost taken away.
Eric Riggins is up, ready to report in, and we haven't played but about 30 seconds. His quick substitution was fortuitous in the first half, but I don't see anybody limping out there.
Moore has the touch this afternoon. He now has 8 points.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, though. If I were guarding him, I'd sure be delighted to see him fall away.
Good pass by Davis into Gattison. And the whistle in traffic underneath the hoop. Now Riggins is coming in the ball game.
Foul by Lloyd Moore. His second personal foul. Eric Riggins, number 00.
Lloyd Moore has 2 personal fouls. Steve Perry now goes out.
Kenny Gattison
at the line. The score, Rutgers 47, Old Dominion 37. Early here in the second half.
He has been very impressive. Gattison, big games in scoring, showing agility at the front of the press. Very eely inside. Has power forward potential for the NBA.
And Moore with the rebound. Rutgers led by 13 in the first half. And Old Dominion is staying close enough within hailing distance, trailing now by 9 points. Battle. That's his third miss after 7 in a row to start the game. Keith Thomas to Davis. Beautiful play. Oh, miss there. Basket is good. The follow-up is made, as you saw. Gattison now has 16 points, following very nicely in that play.
He can really motor for a big guy. Here's the break. 2-on-1. Mark Davis should have used the board on that one. Tried to go over the rim, and as hard as he was going, look, his momentum has carried him almost into the band. But there's the main man, Kenny Gattison, number 44, following up.
The foul was against Steve Brown. Score of the game now is Rutgers 47, Old Dominion 40. Steve Brown, guarded by Smith. Remley, and Smith goes over on the play and is called on the foul. He switched men, went out there and bumped, as you saw.
Well, number 20, Charlie Smith, tried to get the jump switch, and we talked about his durability in 97 consecutive starts. It was a good call. He got in there a little bit late. All-tourney Sunbelt player. Good athlete. Good quickness.
A lot of players have two fouls, but nobody more for either side. Rutgers up by seven in the first 2 minutes of play. Second half. The battle for third place in the 33rd Holiday Festival in the Arc. The E.C.A.C. Holiday Festival palming the ball. Loses it. Four conferences represented. St. John's of the Big East. NC State Atlantic Coast. And these two teams, as we told you, Rutgers Atlantic 10 and Old Dominion Sunbelt. Charlie Smith, closely pursued, gets it off. Moore. You know, Moore had rather a silent game in the opener, and he's now really come to life in this game, Bucky.
Yeah, he had one streak, went for about 8 points there, and again, the conditioning is the factor. He was highly recruited. He was a name player and went to Marquette, decided to transfer, and between the layout to become eligible and a series of nagging injuries, the weight just got away from him. Tom Young believes that that he can do it in the center spot as soon as he gets in shape.
Last foul was on Davis as Rutgers has the ball in front court with Battle.
In fact, Tom Young goes a step further. He thinks that Moore is a better offensive player than Hinson and Bailey. Two fine centers, recent vintage for Rutgers. When he gets in shape, always that qualifying statement.
Just saw one of the charming cheerleaders climbing to the heights. That foul, by the way, was the third foul on Keith Thomas. He's the first player for either side to have three. Battle. Battle, after making the first seven, has now missed his last four. So the law of averages is catching up.
There's something not good happening for Rutgers right now. With no Brian Ellerby in there, and Battle going a little cold early. Here's a good release. Everything looks fine, except that hand did not follow through. If you notice, that palm stayed perpendicular to the floor. When he was drilling it in the first half, it was coming over the top nicely with a good release. And when he missed, it was soft on the rim. We had several follow-ups.
That pass intended for Hanley, knocked out of bounds by Rutgers. Zucker now reappears, and Riggins moved to the sidelines.
I take that back. We had one follow-up because he only missed one when there was a chance for an offensive rebound, and Zucker put it back in.
Mark Davis finding opening right down the middle. Riggins, by the way, also has three fouls now, along with Thomas. Score 47-42. Old Dominion has whittled a 13-point deficit down to five.
I think the key to this game for Rutgers is going to be Steve Brown, because he's going to have to handle the ball against a good press.
Nobody called a foul that time. Battle with the pass to Moore.
It was about seven on the Richter scale, but he got a little cha-cha move in there to get some momentum. Tom Young says, nope, let's talk about it. Trying to preserve that lead.
And we've got a timeout. So we'll be back with a lot of the other action in the second half in just a moment. From Madison Square Garden, this is College Basketball.
It's the granddaddy of all cops and robbers shows, and it's classic television. It's The Untouchables, and you can see it every night at 11 p.m. on Madison Square Garden Network. The Untouchables was a pioneer in action-packed drama, and the four-time Emmy Award winner was a showcase for many prominent careers, including Robert Stack as Elliot Ness. It's big city law enforcement during the Roaring 20s on The Untouchables, every night at 11 p.m. on Madison Square Garden Network.
That's right.
One of the most popular shows in New York is back, and MSG Network has it. It features a team of dedicated professionals led by a hero that does the amazing night after night. He's backed by the powerful and the quick, and they can take whatever the opposition throws at them and then dish it right back. And they're all under the watchful eye of a coach who demands the best. It's New York Knicks basketball. Watch Bernard King, Coach Hubie Brown, and the Knicks take on the NBA's best at Madison Square Garden. New York Knicks home games. There's only one place, Madison Square Garden Network.
Here's the score of this game now. Rutgers leading 47-42. And after this one, they'll go for the championship. Two teams hoping to go all the way this season. St. John's, North Carolina State, both with 7-1 records, will go at it in the finale. This program is authorized by Madison Square Garden Productions Incorporated solely for the entertainment of our audience. In any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this event, including the imposition of a charge for viewing the program without the express written consent of Madison Square Garden Productions Incorporated, is prohibited. The announcers on this telecast were selected by Madison Square Garden Productions Incorporated. We're in the second half, Old Dominion against Rutgers, and Rutgers leads 47-42.
Rutgers shifting to a flat 1-2-2, trying to match up a little bit. Steve Brown, minuscule in there, trying to drop back in on the 6'10 Hanley.
The miss by Keith Thomas. Moore with the rebound, and Steve Brown moving into front court. Zucker, all by himself, misses inside.
Kenny Gaddison. Bob Wolf, Kenny Gaddison came from nowhere. Now, admittedly, the Old Dominion front court was just lazy getting back, but he made a marvelous, just a great physical effort just to get over there and distract that shot.
And distracting was just what it was, Bucky. The footsteps were coming down pretty hard. Thomas, Mark Davis, from the corner, Charlie Smith. Well, they're having the open shots, but of course, from pretty good range. Mark Davis intercepts his 3-on-2. Charlie Smith, he feeds, and it is Gaddison hit by Steve Brown. Brown was on one side, Lloyd Moore on the other.
I think they may have called it on Moore.
Possibly so. Let's see who they call it on. They did.
Yes.
It was on Moore.
All right, the aggressive Monarchs in transition now. A little careless. Steve Brown throws that ball up there, and Mark Davis picks it off. It's 3-on-2, under control. Actually, almost a charge in there on Moore. And the fumbled ball by Gaddison enabled Moore to get over there. Could have been a break for Old Dominion. Eric Riggins back in the game.
Well, these free throws can be a great benefit now to Old Dominion. They have now whittled the lead down to 4. One of the turning points of this, Bucky, was the fact that Battle, who was so hot in the beginning, helped Rutgers spurt to an early lead, and now he's cooled off here in the second half.
Well, it just hasn't gone well. We've played 4 minutes, and Rutgers has come up with 2 points. Battle's not hitting. Ellerbe re-injured that shoulder, and right now this is a Rutgers team that needs a spark.
Look at the press by Old Dominion. Sylvester Charles is coming back in the lineup for them. And Old Dominion showing a good press as Steve Brown gets the ball over to Battle. Battle hits. So Battle now has his first basket of the second half. 20 points in the ball game and all. He sparked Rutgers during the first half. Was missing early in the second. That's how he fares for the rest of this encounter. Rutgers is up by 5 again. Charlie Smith. Davis. Was there a push off there?
Yes, there was. And it was a good call. It's just a little push. Mark Davis trying to get a little room.
I mean, little pushes only count for one free throw?
Yeah, they don't count at all unless you get caught. Here's the main man. Big job.
Wow. We got a block this time on Charlie Smith.
So far, Steve Brown showing lots of poise in that trigger position of point guard for Rutgers. He's got big shoes to fill. He looks like he's got it together.
Charlie Smith jumps in and takes pretty good punishment, doesn't he?
Yeah, this Old Dominion team has good quickness on the perimeter. They jump well, they run well, they play the good D. It's a good basketball team. 4 good ones in this tournament. The 33rd E.C.A.C. Holiday Festival. Still, in most agree, the best of the holiday tournaments.
Now we have changes. Charlie Smith leaves the ball game.
Unless you like palm trees.
Keith Thomas also goes out. Darryl Tolson moves back in. Frank Smith is in for Old Dominion. Rutgers up by 5. Battle. And Old Dominion is back in the zone. Battle on the outside. Remley in the corner.
Tolson at 6'5", number 35 on the top of that zone. It's going to be a little tougher to shoot over.
They keep looking for Riggins. He's pretty well surrounded. Battle to Riggins.
Well, they had the spot there. Battles gets it back. And is hit. Goes down, little battle scarred on the play, but he'll be up.
Boy, he's strong. He really is strong. Now you look at their starting guards, John Battle and Brian Ellerby, and they're really tough, strong-looking guards. And you look at their front court, and with the exception of Lloyd Moore, they're all extremely, and I underline, extremely thin.
Tolson committed the foul. And here's how the foul shape up right now is Old Dominion, as you know, is over the limit, and Rutgers at the four-foul mark.
In the earlier encounter, in addition to not being able to contain Walter Berry and Bill Wennington, Rutgers against St. John's really struggled in the backcourt. Ellerby had not yet returned, and John Battle was trying to be the point guard, and they were trying to tempo a little bit, and it just was a disaster. It's been a marked difference with Ellerby in there.
Battle now has 22, and Rutgers leads 51-44. Time left to go in the second half, over 14 minutes, so we're a long way from the climax of this game. Tolson. Battle is guarding him. In the corner, this is Frank Smith, not about to shoot from there. Gaddison trying to get free along the baseline, comes out to meet the ball. This is he. And Frank Smith launches it. A little off balance as he did. Sort of forced the ball slightly. Look how close Tolson is up on Battle.
Conditioning, Bob Wolf might be a factor.
This fast break up front is Tolson. And what a play that time. Steve Brown sprinted to the other side, moved in quickly, but did commit the foul.
It just intercepted what I was going to say. Steve Brown has not had that much playing time. He's sucking a little air out there, and that time he just flat got beat. Old Dominion threw the ball right over his head, and as the back man, and there was no question about who had back responsibility. Watch him down there. He's got a hold of his trunks, and in that fit, there he is at the top of the key, and he is sucking air. And he's going to have to go this whole half. Well, without Ellerby, and this is going to be a key, because Old Dominion can flat pressure. Mm-hmm.
We saw the change made just a moment ago as Campbell came in, the Zucker.
Lloyd Moore now is back in the game, and he's a little scary as a trigger man, too. The big man gets right underneath that basket and can't throw it long, which gives Old Dominion the license to get right up there and take away the inside passing lanes. Let's see if they repeat it.
51 Rutgers, 46 Old Dominion. Old Dominion again with that press. They have a triple team over there. This is Campbell now for Rutgers. Steve Brown, they're going against Frank Smith. Too small, but quick guards. And on the play inside, Riggins with the ball taken away. Gaddison, this is Frank Smith looking up court. Feeds in the corner to Davis. Tolson. Gaddison and Frank Smith from the corner. Rebound Davis. There was a push there. Battle did the pushing. There's Tom Young doing the pacing with his ever-present towel.
Had an 8-point lead at the half, and he's nursing it now.
He is now five. Rutgers has now used up all of their team fouls. Old Dominion is over the limit. Frank Smith under the glass, a little shoving going on. There was the push. So the call's being made on this one.
Followed by Sylvester Charles.
Sylvester Charles, so we move to the other end of the court.
That's Charles' third personal foul, three of Charles.
Very well officiated game, by the way. Both these teams pressing, running, attacking the basket. You want to know where the beef is? It's in the second game today, folks.
Is that it?
Yes. Both North Carolina State and St. John's, very physical up front. Very physical.
At the line, we have Darren Campbell. Time left to go is 12:54 in the second half. Rutgers with a 5-point lead. Darren Campbell, another player from Washington, D.C., where
Rutgers has done a lot of recruiting. They've got some great basketball teams there.
Yeah, and there's a reason for it, too. Tom Young, of course, played at Maryland and coached at American University and was an assistant coach at Maryland. So he has long, deep-seated ties there. As you pointed out, Washington, D.C., one of the, it's always arguable where they produce the most and best, but certainly Washington, D.C., one of the hotbeds of talent.
Old Dominion also does some recruiting in that area as well, not to be outdone. Sylvester Charles played at Dunbar. They have the number one ranking during the senior year. And they've got other players in there as well. Score 53-46. Gaddison gets a second chance. And this time he does it. That was a big play for them, Bucky.
Superb second effort. Tom Young lamenting the fact that he cannot contain power. Watch now. Watch how quickly he gets back to the floor, coming back on that offensive board. Offensive rebounding is a sense, but most of all, it's effort. The guys who want to play in a tuxedo, fire and fall back. Your good players find a way to get back on there, and if it goes through, they're basically there to catch it. They're around the rim.
Not only did Gaddison make the big play right there, but the foul called on the play, and Moore now has four. Now we have Ronnie Wade, number 22 in Old Dominion.
Wade was a starter last year until he had ankle problems, so he's experienced and a good player.
Gaddison now has 21 points. He's just 1 point behind the total amassed by Battle. Riggins, beautiful play. 55-49, Rutgers is leading. 12:20 to go in the second half of play. This is Wade, number 22, inside Gaddison. And Gaddison, oh, room topple.
He's got a nice touch, though. Even when he misses, it hangs soft around the rim. Look for Sylvester Charles or Wade to come back in there and put it back in. Rutgers is not a good rebounding team. As we pointed out, they've been hammered three times in this season, all by teams with power games inside. Michigan on the road, St. John's, and North Carolina State on Thursday night in the first round of the E.C.A.C. Holiday Tournament.
Foul was by Bell. Sam Randolph is in the lineup for Rutgers now. He's number 22, comes from Trenton, 6'2 senior.
Tom Young getting ready for the Atlantic 10 Conference, playing a lot of people.
Gaddison not only has sparkled offensively, that's he putting the ball in the basket, he's also contributed 10 rebounds. And Gaddison right now has tied Battle for scoring honors with 22 points apiece. 55-50, one of the headlines of the Holiday Festival is always who's going to be the MVP. They've had some of the greatest names in basketball won the MVP. Double dribble is the call.
Well, there are two guards in the running. Mike Moses from St. John's had a sensational game on Thursday night, as did Spud Webb, the 5'7 spark plug of North Carolina State, who came off the bench and really, at a one-man show, ignited the Wolfpack to get him into the championship game.
Old Dominion's Tulsa. And Frank Smith. Rebound, Charles. Good play. Remley, Gaddison, Frank Smith. This Gaddison is being a big spark plug. Good pass. And the two-pointer by Tolson. Tolson has 7 points. Now Old Dominion has pulled within 1 point of Rutgers with 11:25 to go in the half. Rutgers 55, Old Dominion 54. They just have stayed in there, Bucky.
Yeah, there
look
it is
at the
again.
Steal. Frank Smith up front is Wade, but Frank Smith says, I'll take it. And now Old Dominion has also taken the lead at 56-55. Well, when Ellaby went out for Rutgers, that seemed to change things, did it not? Well, let's see what develops in the last 11 minutes. We'll be back then.
Do you know which of these oils gives you the best engine protection under the toughest driving conditions, sub-zero cold or blazing heat? This one, Mobil 1.
Now, buy 5 quarts of Mobil 1 in this easy-pour plastic container, and Mobil will send you a $5 rebate on the oil that helps you get started, even down at 35 below.
Taxi!
Over 19 million times a year, people take off with us to cities all across America. Maybe it's because we can take them to more places than American, TWA, United, and Delta combined. What? Or maybe they just like taking off without leaving the ground.
All aboard! All aboard! All aboard Amtrak!
Take Amtrak now and take advantage of our All Aboard America fares.
There we see the great All-American, former member of the U.S. Olympic team, the gold medal team this year, Chris Mullen, and Frank McGuire right beside him, the famed coach, Hall of Famer. Frank is the director of intercollegiate athletics, Madison Square Garden. And 50 years ago today, in the first doubleheader at Madison Square Garden, he scored 8 points for St. John's.
Well, those are two of the all-time greats at St. John's, and Frank McGuire was coaching Zeke Zawalek. And that's the record, Bob Zawalek's record of I don't know how many points, but a ton that Chris Mullen just broke recently. Chris, is, of course, has most of his senior year remaining, but measuring Mullins in points is a great injustice. He's the Bill Bradley of the 80s.
Oh, there's the steal. Keith Thomas goes up. The tap-in. Wade was up there reaching for it with the tap. Here's Remley. And Remley gets two back. And look at the pace of the game now. As Rutgers still trails by a point, Old Dominion took the lead after trailing by 13. And now Old Dominion, the Monarchs, lead 58-57. Things have really sparkled here at the Garden. Frank Smith, rebound by Battle.
It's key for Old Dominion to score so that they can set up that press, because right now Rutgers' attack against that press has been an adventure. Randolph in the game was stripped as they were trying to rest Steve Brown. And there's no Brian Ellerby, and that's trouble against the press for Rutgers.
Gaddison tipped that ball over to Wade as Frank Smith, and you can see psychologically that OGU just seems to have found the spark with this lead, now playing with tremendous confidence.
Well, they really haven't changed a thing tactically. They're just wearing Rutgers down.
Cross court, Wade. Inside is Gaddison, that's he. Triple team, the ball off his toe and put up by Thomas, but we've got a whistle and a 3-second violation.
3-second violation, Ronnie Wade in the lane.
Without Brian Ellerby, a little shaky in the backcourt is Rutgers, trying to dribble up against three blue shirts. It's taken from behind and we're going the other way. Keith Thomas, number 24, takes it right to the paint, goes up over everybody, and look at that offensive rebounding. Looked like Wade that got that tip.
The assist man and the point guard who keeps feeding usually doesn't get all that credit, all the headlines. The big scorers do, but you can see the worth of Ellaby. He was out now with a dislocated shoulder. Remley. Good shot from outside. He's a good outside shooter.
Outside, that was almost outdoors.
It's a long way. Rutgers now regains the lead by one, 59-58. We're past the midway point in the second half. Wade, Thomas, Gaddison in low. Good position. Travel. That nullifies the basket.
Well, he may have traveled, but he sure left some white jerseys in his wake.
Mark Davis reappears, replacing Wade.
The quickness on the front of this Old Dominion press is very good, and when you get through to the other end, you've got Sylvester Charles and Kenny Gaddison, and that could be a challenge.
Rutgers leads by a point. Riggins, they lead by three. 61-58. Sylvester Charles is in the low post. Riggins is staying with him, and Sylvester Charles is up with the ball. Foul. Riggins gambled that time on moving in front to try to snare the ball there.
Rutgers going to man for man now, trying to get a little better coverage. Hopefully limit Old Dominion to one shot. Very tough to do. Gaddison, Sylvester Charles, and a fine array of wing people hitting that offensive board. Closing Rutgers, lots of problems.
Now Hanley is back in. Charlie Smith is in along with Thomas. Sylvester Charles is at the line.
Both of these coaches are using their bench well. Steve Perry, of course, one of the starters, along with Brian Ellerbe. Perry has not made an appearance in this half. So that ankle injury that he suffered very early in the game must be more severe than we earlier noted.
Charles. And both misses for Sylvester Charles, who's really had his problems at the free throw line, as we pointed out, despite his proficiency from the floor. Steve Brown. Battle. Thomas is on him. Playing him very tight. Charlie Smith running Brown. Good pass into Riggins. 63-58, Rutgers lead, the Scarlet Knights. Riggins now has 16 points. Thomas now has six. 63-60. Rutgers out in front. Time left to go, 8:05.
I'm not sure what to call this.
It's a technical foul charge against Sylvester Charles.
He broke the plane on the press. Sylvester Charles on the point of the Old Dominion zone trap is not allowed to break the plane over the end line. In other words, you're not allowed to reach out of bounds and slap the ball. Normally you're warned once, I'm sure he was, but that was the call.
And Remley profited by putting the ball up and in to give Rutgers a 4-point lead. Battle. Now John Battle has 24 points.
Both of these teams playing in spurts. That's his shot.
Hanley.
Clarence Moose Hanley.
He likes to shoot from outside despite his 6'10", 240-pound size.
He's much more effective out there. And with Gattison inside, it's a nice combination.
Rutgers leads by four. 7.5 left to play in the second half. Remley with a good fake getting shooting room.
Nice touch.
Wasn't that a soft one?
Boy, when you're shooting at 20 feet and it hangs around the iron, you've got a good backspin, good release on that ball.
And a quick release that time by Charlie Smith. He's got 10 points. Rutgers up by four.
The analogy there is just like a Jack Nicklaus wedge shot. When you see him coming into the pin and the ball hits and backs up, that's the same kind of spin and trajectory that your good shooters have. Very few maintain the flat shot.
Sylvester Charles' foul was his fourth. And Charles is leaving the ball game as Gattison comes in. Lloyd Moore right beside Hanley along the line. That's a lot of heft. Steve Brown getting set at the free throw line. Zucker now replaces Andre Bell. So we've seen frequent changes for both of these lineups.
Clarence Moose Hanley is giving away. Moose is giving away 30 pounds to Lloyd Moore. It's Moose too.
Cool shooting by Steve Brown. Here's Tolson. In for Davis.
Lloyd Moore has four fouls. I don't know with 7:10 to go whether Coach Paul Webb will really fool around much with trying a special play to get that fifth one on Moore. I think at this point he just may go ahead and play.
Another soft touch, and we've got timeout taken.
Moore has a tendency though to play well after he's been rested, and just coming back in the game he usually does well for them.
7:10 left to go in this half. Rutgers now leads by six, 70-64. You're watching college basketball from Madison Square Garden.
For seven decades, professional boxing and Madison Square Garden have been the sports world's most illustrious combination. Today, the tradition continues with the area's finest professional boxers squaring off at the Felt Forum. Month after month, the Felt Forum is the site for top-notch fights in all weight divisions, and you can be on hand to see it. Just call the Garden Box Office at 564-4400 for ticket information. Professional boxing and the Felt Forum, a winning combination all year round.
Take it from a former member, a boys club is a lot more than just a club.
It's a class.
It's a sport. It's a skill and support.
Hey, there's no guarantee a boys' club will turn every kid into a star, but it'll sure teach them how to reach for one.
It's a place to grow. It's a place to meet. It's a place to go besides the street.
Support your local boys' club. It's the club that beats the street.
On the left, we see Dave DeBuscher, one of the all-time greats of basketball, Hall of Famer. Sparkled on the Knicks championship team, is now the head of the basketball operations for the New York Knicks.
Seeing some good talent here in this tournament. John Battle, of course, the senior guard from Rutgers in this game. Probably the top prospect. Dave DeBuscher is having a long year. He and Coach Hubie Brown, Knicks, lots of injuries, struggling. But that pro season is oh so long, Bob Wolf.
That it is. More injuries this year, Bucky, than ever before.
Yeah.
Rutgers 70, Old Dominion 64, went out under the 7 minute mark in the second half. Charlie Smith, and there's Hanley following. Remley got the rebound for the Scarlet Knights. This is Steve Brown finding a pass. And an offensive foul.
Steve Brown showing a little inexperience there. Taking the ball down and really didn't have any place to go. He was OOC, out of control. That's a time with a 6-point lead. I'm sure Tom Young would like for him to have pulled that thing up and gone to the offense. I go back to the point I made right at the start of the second half. I think Steve Brown's going to be the key to Rutgers winning this game. He's going to be controlling the ball. And for 6 minutes and 41 seconds, he's going to face one of the better presses he's going to see all year.
That was Keith Thomas on the miss of the lines in the 1-1. Battle. Rebound by Gaddison was a big one.
Keith Thomas putting great pressure on Battle. Battle's so strong, he just manages to get up over everybody.
And Gaddison, rebound. Oh, did you see that? As Brown came over, he poked Tolson, who got the rebound. Tolson was hit actually in the side of the face, it appeared.
Followed by Steve Brown.
1-1.
That's his fourth personal foul for Steve Brown.
So Darryl Tolson.
Darryl Tolson on the line.
6'5 junior at the line. And these free throws now are important for both sides. Both teams in the bonus situation. Last time Old Dominion was there, they missed in that opportunity. 70-65. Here's Campbell moving back in the lineup for Rutgers. And Brown departs.
Old Dominion only shooting 63% from the foul line. They were a very good free throw shooting team last year. Up around 80, 79 and change, as I recall. Boy, they'll kill you in these kind of games.
And Tolson, in fact, Keith Thomas missed his last one-on-one opportunity. He is the two-time Sun Belt Conference free throw leader. Here's the field goal percentage, Bucky.
Well, about even in the second half, Rutgers with that superb first half, 64%, mostly John Battle, 7-for-9. So Old Dominion has played itself back in this game and wearing them down.
Old Dominion trails by 4. Interception that time by Hanley. Pass intended for Moore. Smith's pass inside, and it goes out of bounds, was knocked out of bounds. Knocked out of bounds by Zucker coming in there. And Charlie Smith with the ball play. Here's Riggins re-entering the game.
Charlie Smith is one of those players that's quick with the ball. As we pointed out earlier, quickness is one thing. Being able to take the ball with you is another.
Thomas. And Smith. Oh, what a play. Clarence Hanley went up and ran that hole with a one-handed dunk from the left-hand side. That pulls Old Dominion within 2. That was a sensational effort.
Well, he's a candidate for MVP because without him, Old Dominion really doesn't have any kind of shot in this tournament. He has played really well 2 games.
Riggins.
Look at that score right there. That'll give time to go back to the right player.
Pete Thomas.
We're talking offensive rebounding here, folks. Watch number 44, Gaddison, get this errant shot by Charlie Smith. It's off the iron, but it's soft. Left hand, one hand, he controls the ball and blows by Eric Riggins. Of course, at the other end, it was a defensive breakdown by the Monarchs. Nobody home. The weak side defense out to lunch. And for his embarrassment on the other end, Eric Riggins equals the score.
And at the line, it's battle. 1-1. Rutgers leading by two.
Crowd starting to come in now for the championship game. They're going to be treated to an outstanding 5 minutes and 2 seconds. These are exciting teams. They really, really are good at the transition.
74-70 Rutgers with 5 minutes to play. Old Dominion looking for the right shot right now, and Davis in that corner thought better of it. Rutgers in the zone. From outside, Hanley. From inside, Moore rebounds. 4.5 minutes.
It appears Old Dominion on the half-court offense going to their big men, either Hanley or Gaddison down underneath.
Battle with shooting room. Riggins there for the rebound, won't go. Hanley gets it for Old Dominion. Charlie Smith, let's fly. Battle. Approaching 4 minutes. Rutgers is up by four.
Smith having a cold spell right through here. ODU has had opportunities.
There was a kick. Frank Smith coming back in the lineup. Charlie Smith goes out. Paul Webb pacing.
Paul Webb countering. Yeah, Charlie Smith was with all kind of offensive opportunities. Couldn't get it down.
He's gone 5 for 15. Steve Brown, Remley. That's Riggins inside, Gaddison guarding him. The shooting has grown very cold for both sides coming down the home stretch.
I'll tell you though, every shot, every shooter's having his tonsils checked. It's tough in there.
Tolson hit the side of the backboard. Watch it. I thought they were coming at you, Bucky.
No.
Here's Steve Brown.
He wasn't coming.
Nobody can hit now. Tapped in.
He was trying to avoid Lloyd Moore.
Lloyd Moore with that big tap in makes the score 76-70 Rutgers. And here is Gaddison, and the basket does count.
Old Dominion has to be a tired team. The last two shots from the outside have hit the corner of the board. Again, Gaddison saving him inside with his effort and his skill.
Gaddison has 26 points, matching Battle. Battle in the first half at 18, and Gaddison 13, now both with 26. And Gaddison has a chance now to pull out for individual scoring honors, but also get Old Dominion even closer, as he does. They're within three. 3:17 left to play. We're seeing some game, and there's 3:17 to go. Rutgers up by three. We'll be back with more action in a moment.
The car won't start.
Winter driving can mean trouble, but plain gas line antifreeze often can't help. STP gas treatment does more. It tunes up your gas for better performance. Used regularly, STP helps break up water in your tank to remove it, helps clear your fuel line, and cleans your carburetor. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Oh, yes, Daddy's coming!
Don't get stopped cold. Get STP gas treatment and tune up your gas.
STP,
your car care company.
I got a bad feeling about this.
By axe.
Ralph?
By hook. By blade. By bye. Mutilator from OK Productions.
Let's take a look now at the leading scorers in the game. For Rutgers University, Battle, of course, has been up there on top. Riggins has 18, Battle with 26. Old Dominion, Gaddison, now is 27. He's leading both teams. And Charlie Smith is 9. Here are the foul difficulties. You can see Moore and Brown up there. Charles for Old Dominion. And the time left to go is 3:17. The score, Rutgers 76, Old Dominion 73. Look at that press. Here's Remley helping out. They got 3 men to bring in from back to front court. And just barely get it over in 10 seconds. Riggins, but the bodies were bumping, and Riggins is called on the foul.
Well, Rutgers trying to bring that ball up without Ellerby is an adventure every time. And we remind you, if you're looking for the fine point guard from Rutgers, Brian Ellerby, he has re-injured that left shoulder. It is dislocated, and there has been no time frame given for his return.
That's the fourth foul on Riggins. We move under the 3-minute mark. Old Dominion trailing by 3. Rutgers leads 76-73. The miss by Smith, the grab by Gaddison, and Gaddison was pushed. No, they call it travel. Apparently they felt there was no push, it was just a stumble, and that's the way they call it. So there we have a big decision.
I'll tell you what, Kenny Gaddison is 6'8 and about 220, and he's not clumsy. And we went flying across there. He did get a nudge. It's a lane violation. You can run that lane after a score. That was after a violation. And basically, Chris Remley had to maintain a pivot foot. He did not. A big break for ODU.
19 turnovers for Rutgers, 10 for Old Dominion, and that was a big one. Old Dominion trailing by 3 with under 3 minutes to go now. Davis.
You know, the thing about Old Dominion coming in here was the balanced scoring. 5 starters and double figures. But in this tournament, basically, it's been Gaddison.
Tolson. Big basket by Tolson. Old Dominion trails by a point. The Scarlet Knights. Old Dominion puts on the press, and the ball is grabbed. This is Gaddison going in. Wow. Old Dominion leads. Gaddison's big play. Here's Riggins. Riggins feeds right into the hands of Davis, his opponent. Over it goes to Frank Smith behind his back. Frank Smith passes Gaddison, puts it in. What a play.
Rutgers needs a timeout.
What a play. Old Dominion leads by 3, 79-76, with 2:02 to go. And the Old Dominion fans are going wild. How about that, Bucky Waters?
Well, that press, the Old Dominion press, and as we talked about early on, it's just wearing them down. Right now, Rutgers is a tired basketball team.
Gaddison now has 31 points. He has become the big headliner of this game.
And he so far has my vote for MVP.
He is just playing sensational and spectacular plays.
Steve Smith loses it. And he was triple teamed on that, but basically he lost his footing. And as we said early on, Smith is really in trouble here. Riggins now coming down, pressing, one on two, tries a double clutch, has no place to go, puts the ball right in the hands of Mark Davis, and it's the Monarchs going, look at this move. Frank Davis, little stutter step, excuse me. And now the tomahawk, well, the tomahawk on the first one, he was just a little bit off balance on that one.
The complexion of this game has completely changed around. Old Dominion leading now 79-76, and now it's up to the Rutgers Scarlet Knights to see if they can battle back against the Monarchs. Coach Paul Webb, 3 victories away from his 500th college coaching record, hoping to get this one here at Madison Square Garden in Old Dominion's first visit to Madison Square Garden. And we're seeing a tremendous climax, and a reminder that this is just the first game of 2 today at the Garden. The St. John's Redmen go against the North Carolina State Wolfpack in the championship game. But there you see the man who'll be written about tomorrow, and look at the numbers of the points and the rebounds. Yes, sir, he has done the job. Kenny Gaddison went to New Hanover High School. He comes from Wilmington, North Carolina, and he is doing an outstanding job.
Okay, that time Remling ran the baseline, but it was all right. It was after a score.
Battle misses, and Riggins puts it in. Now we're down to a one-point game. Old Dominion leading 79-78, and we're under the 2-minute mark.
Both of these teams could sure score points in a hurry.
This has been a game. One team would sort of spurt, and the other team, and they'd both coast, and then the energy kicked up, and coming down these last minutes of play, it has been an exciting and whirlwind finish. And there's still a minute and a half to go. Oh, close. There you saw Brown reach in. Steve Brown, too enthusiastically. That's his fifth foul. He's out of the ball game.
Powered by Steve Brown. That's his fifth personal foul. Steve Brown was perhaps
not ready to replace a Brian Ellerbe, Sam Randolph, in his brief appearance earlier, really had difficulty, was stripped. And he now, with a minute and 28 seconds to go, is going to be the distributor against the fine press. And I'm sure that's going to put a few gray hairs in Tom Young's head. A few more.
A one-point difference. Fans still arriving. Should be a large crowd. They're all assembled. And at the line right now, we have Charlie Smith. Sam Randolph is in. Placing Steve Brown, guard spot for Rutgers. One and one. Kept alive by Hanley. Time left to go, a minute, 25 seconds. Davis with the ball. Old Dominion, 1 point lead. And the seconds tick on the clock.
Neither of these teams look very good trying to play cat and mouse. Both are much better in motion.
A minute 10. Hanley. War has come out on him. Time left to go, a minute and a few seconds. We're at the minute mark. Davis gets it out, under the minute mark now. Well, Old Dominion, 1 point lead.
The real test here is you gotta keep looking for the basket. You're playing keep away. The percentage.
Whoop, that almost got away.
A little thrill there.
There's the bump by Randolph. The clock stops with 45 seconds left to go. Both teams 1-1 at this point. 45 seconds left. Now here's where the pressure comes on, as Tom Young is exhibiting what he wants done out there.
Well, he's a little upset that after the last missed free throw, Lloyd Moore let that ball go over his head. Old Dominion got the possession back. You pray for those missed free throws at this time in the game, and it's just a killer when the other team is able to get possession back.
Mark Davis, 1-1. Big one for Old Dominion. It's 80-78. 45 seconds left to go, and Mark Davis from Chesapeake, Virginia, a 6'5 senior and a co-captain, is at the line. Charlie Smith, the other coach after.
Kenny Gaddison is only a 47% free throw shooter. So from a priority standpoint, if Rutgers has to foul fast and quick, it should be Gaddison.
Rutgers trails by three. Riggins. Riggins shoots. Hits. Timeout is called by Rutgers. The score of the game is Old Dominion 81 and Rutgers 80. We have 32 seconds left in the game.
In the chess game, Rutgers has no timeouts left. Old Dominion, by the scoreboard, has four.
We have a quick moment now to bring you the scoring leaders, Battle 26, but he hasn't been as hot in the second half. He had 18 of those in the first half. Gaddison has 31 points. Remley, 13. Moore is 10. Ellaby is 2. 22 for Riggins. Steve Brown is 3. And the rest of the Old Dominion scoring. Davis has 12. Hanley has 2. Charlie Smith, 10. Thomas is 8. Frank Smith, 2, 3 for Charles, 11 for Tolson. But the big aspect right now is not the individual scoring, but who's going to take this ball game, which is really up for grabs. Old Dominion leads by a point, 32 seconds to go. And don't forget, this is just the beginning. Coming up, St. John's University against NC State for the championship. Both teams with 7-1 records. Some climax that will be to this 33rd holiday festival at Madison Square Garden, where it all began 50 years ago in college basketball.
To the day, Bob Wolf, to the day. 32 seconds left. And we could be around here for a while, the way these two teams have scored in a hurry. Gaddison again, the foul priority, number 44. Everybody else on the floor for the Monarchs, a good free throw shooter.
Davis. And the pass, it almost out of bounds. Hanley Over to Davis, went out of 25 seconds. The seconds are now ticking. 22 seconds, 21 seconds, and Davis, who got his last two on the one-and-one, fouled by Randolph. And let's see what Davis does now. Talk about pressure. Yes, sir, he's going right there. This is Mark Davis.
I'm sure by design that Paul Webb doesn't want Gattison handling that ball at this particular juncture unless it's an open layup underneath. I'm sure he's well aware of the foul shooting potential of the team on the floor.
He's a cool customer. It's 82 to 80. 21 seconds left to go. Old Dominion with the lead.
Have to credit both of these coaches. A third place game at 12:30 in the afternoon, and both of these teams came to play.
Now Rutgers has to rush it down. We're under the 20-second mark. They trail by two. 82 to 80 is the score. Battle with the ball. Battle looking to... Battle seemed to get hurt on that one. Now he presses inside. The shot won't go. Riggins tried it, couldn't go. Here's the ball. Scramble. It goes out of bounds. Who's going to get it? It goes to Old Dominion. Without a 1 second of the game. That was a crucial across the end line call. Old Dominion has it with a second to go. They lead by two, 82 to 80. Let's take a look at that.
Well, before I say anything, I want to look at it. Rutgers, a heartbreaking second half. Watch, they get an easy shot here, a little bit of a nudge, could have been a foul, rolls off the iron. They just can't. Remley has his hands on it here. And there's no question that ball was off number 24 for Old Dominion. No question about it. Keith Thomas hit that ball out of bounds. But that's one of the breaks of the game. You have to credit Old Dominion for a good comeback. But you also have to think about Rutgers with an 8-point lead and losing Ellerby. And, it's just been that kind of year for the Scarlet Knights. Now, on the inbounds play, the one thing that they have to be careful not to do, it will be Old Dominion inbounding. And strangely enough, they called for the timeout, which is a very unusual situation because they're giving Rutgers a chance to set up the defense. The first thing that Paul Webb is saying, now, for goodness sake, don't run the baseline. It's a designated spot, and many players get confused on that and think along the baseline that they can motor. So the first thing they're going to do is not move. And the second thing they're going to do is throw it deep. Under no circumstances will that pass, or should that pass, be anywhere around their defensive basket. So even if Rutgers picks it off, they won't have time to do anything but make a desperation fling, as we used to call it in South Jersey.
Pertinent points, Bucky. Boy, that Riggins, I know, will be replaying that in his dreams. That ball went around the rim and came off, didn't it? And the out-of-bounds play, a big call right now. There's a second to go. Old Dominion with the ball. They lead by 2 points. The inbound pass into Keith Thomas. That's the ball game. Old Dominion has defeated Rutgers in the battle for third, 82-80. They came from behind to do it. They trailed by as many as 13. So a most exciting game, the first one of two here at the Holiday Festival. And, of course, we got the championship coming up. St. John's University Redmen, North Carolina State Wolfpack. We also have activities for you. Paul Webb needs just two more victories to get to that 500 plateau. And, of course, Tom Young, one of these days, will also be at that same peak. A very, very exciting game. And now, as you see, Old Dominion has won the ball game, 82-80. Stay tuned for more action. This is college basketball from Madison Square Garden.